What's going on, guys? It's your boy Javon from JVTV Reacts, and welcome back to yet another reaction. Today in this video, guys, I'll be reacting to the top 10 classic British bands to crack the US. The last video I did is bands that never really cracked the US, and I was surprised because some of the bands that were on that list were pretty good in my opinion. I think they deserve to crack the market, but you know, it happened. So today we're going to check out the bands that did crack the US market. Before we get started, I already have an idea. I'm thinking Pink Floyd, Queen, Led Zeppelin. That's who I have in my head so far, but we're going to see if there's any others. Let's check it out.
These icons never go out of style. Welcome to Watch Mojo UK, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 classic British bands to crack the US.
I did not know they were British.
Before we begin, if you enjoy this video, please subscribe for more great content.
Hey guys, make sure you're subscribed
for
if you're not already.
For this list, we'll be ranking the most prominent, popular, and influential British bands to cross over into the American market.
I want to see this.
We'll be considering groups which achieved success prior to the 1990s for this list, while also omitting artists known primarily for their solo work, such as Elton John and David Bowie.
I wasn't thinking about David Bowie and Elton John, but yeah.
Number 10, The Clash.
Oh wow, I forgot about The Clash.
There's a bit of an argument as to...
I forgot about The Clash. Honestly, I need to listen to more of their music, but The Clash, from what I've heard so far, they make some really good music, man. I think they were my first introduction to punk.
Who exactly were the first punk rock band, but there's no denying the impact of The Clash upon groups in America as well as at home. This was due to a wide variety of influences the Clash brought to their sound. It wasn't always about aggression when it came to these Londoners. As songwriters Mick Jones and Joe Strummer sought inspiration from genres as diverse as reggae, dub, and ska.
Oh, I was right. I was like, yo, you know what? I'm pretty good at this, man. I'm pretty good at this. I was like, yo, that kind of sounds like ska music, the way they were singing it.
Then there was Combat Rock, the 1982 album which went double platinum in the US. And features such hit singles as Rock the Casbah and Should I Stay or Should I Go, and the rest as
it's
they
the first
say
song I heard
was
from
history.
Them.
Should I stay or should I go now?
Hey, shout out to The Clash. Oh yes, The Cure. Can't forget The
Number
Cure.
Number 9, The Cure.
Well deserved.
Formed in West Sussex way back in 1976, The Cure were one of the earliest pioneers of goth rock and are still going strong 40 years later. This is thanks largely to the band's rabid fanbase, who sell out the band's 3-hour plus shows whenever the group goes on tour.
I want to see them
one
day.
It was the 1989 album Disintegration, which served as the band's commercial crossroads, ushering them firmly into the American mainstream with such hit singles as Love Song and Pictures of You. They've continued to straddle the line between morose and upbeat pop, ensuring a little cure.
Well deserved, man. The Cure is amazing. Oh, wow.
Number 8, Queen.
Queen. Man, I haven't heard Queen in a while. It's so crazy how the UK, so many great bands that come out of the UK. Like, honestly, most of the bands that I like came out of the UK. It's crazy to think.
There was no band, British or otherwise, past or present, quite like Queen, and no frontman possessing the same level of charisma as Freddie Mercury.
Wow. It still gives me chills, man.
London legends managed to cross over so firmly into America. Audiences around the world gravitated towards the band's quirky, layered rock orchestrations, while Mercury's superstar stage presence and impassioned vocals raised the bar for frontmen everywhere. Even Mercury's 1991 death could stop.
This song is, it don't matter how many times I hear this song now.
Icons, thanks to such huge hits as Bohemian Rhapsody,
I See a Little Silhouette of a Man,
Somebody to Love,
Somebody, Somebody,
and The Show Must Go On.
Show Must Go On.
This was a pretty sad one in my opinion. Oh, The Police. I forgot about it. I didn't even remember that they were British.
Number 7, Roxanne. The Police.
Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red light.
I love
Sting's
voice.
Sometimes the best sort of creativity can arise from the worst sort of tension. This phrase could describe, in part, the lightning-in-a-bottle magic which was The Police, as the London-based group's relationship came to be known as a notoriously bitter one. Still, these stressful working conditions didn't stop bassist-slash-vocalist Sting, guitarist Andy Summers, and drummer Stuart Copeland from creating some of the most unique pop music of the 1980s. The talents of all three men combined in a magical way, delivering thoughtful and intelligent tunes featuring influences from around the world of pop, rock, reggae, and jazz.
Well, honestly, now I think about it, Sting, I think it was Sting, The Police, man, they made some really great songs. Definitely influential, for sure. For some reason, they have this, I really like listening to them perform. I really like hearing Sting's voice. Most of their songs, that they got this reggae, you could tell that they got some reggae influence. They've definitely taken some reggae influence and applied it to their music. But yeah, Sting is pretty good, man.
Number 6, The Who.
You think we look pretty good together.
Diversity, eccentricity, and electricity were part of the course of this progressive group, who thought nothing of writing expansive rock operas alongside short riff rock anthems.
Man.
Singer Roger Daltrey seemed cut from the stone.
I haven't heard The Who in so long, man. Like, The Who is... gosh, I gotta listen to some more music from them. It's been a while since I last even reacted to them. Definitely, man. The Who, Roger Daltrey, his voice is incredible.
Known as the prototypical hard rock frontman, while guitarist and songwriter Pete Townsend was all windmilling energy.
Pete Townsend on the guitar. I haven't heard any of those songs.
The Who seemed to write tunes tailor-made for overseas crossover potential, as proven by the success of radio mainstays Who Are You, I Can't Explain, Substitute, and My Generation.
That's different. With this? Oh!
Number 5, Black Sabbath.
Oh my god.
As he lost his mind, can he see or is he blind?
Wind, rain, and that ominous church bell. These were the sounds which
UK
held the
got
Black
some heavy
Sabbath's
hitters.
1970 self-titled
wow.
debut, a
I did not know
record,
this many.
Which signified the
and
onset
still a lot.
Of heavy metal
that's
into the public consciousness. There were few bands performing over-amplified blues as pounding as Sabbath during this time, and it wasn't only British audiences that started paying attention. Subsequent LPs such as Paranoid, Master of Reality, and Sabbath Bloody Sabbath would garner the Birmingham lads a devout following in the States, one which would continue through multiple lineup shifts and change trends to ensure Black Sabbath's certified icon status.
Pink Floyd, damn. The bass in this song is too clean.
Number 4, Pink Floyd.
All in all, it's just another brick in the wall.
Fans searching for the hazy roots of psychedelic rock need look no further than the discography of these London legends, who pioneered the style during the late 60s before perfecting it in the 1970s.
I've never heard this
Pink
song
Floyd
from them.
Did it all, from loud and noisy to smooth, mellow, and emotional. The group suffered a couple of lineup changes, but remained relevant throughout the years, especially in America, where such albums as The Wall and Dark Side of the Moon saw Floyd's music reach a larger international audience than ever before.
But if you ask
this song is great. Of course.
Number 3, Led Zeppelin. Just as Black Sabbath pioneered heavy metal in the 1970s, so too did their contemporaries led...
So I'll make a prediction. I know they probably have the Beatles number one. I think they might throw an Electrolyte Orchestra in there. Because I know, I think ELO, some of their songs charted in the U.S. I hope they're in it. But yeah, I'll make a prediction. Beatles, of course. But yeah, I already knew Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin gonna be in there.
Zeppelin overhauled blues into something similarly innovative.
Well.
Although these London-based legends had a slightly more sensitive side than Sabbath, embracing diverse...
I think Dire Straits might be in there too.
That didn't stop Zeppelin from crossing over big time in America.
There's also Culture Club.
Jimmy
There's
Page's
so many.
Superb riffing, Robert Plant's epic wail, and the incredible rhythm section of John Bonham and John Paul Jones were second to none during their day, and in the process crafted some of the most enduring rock anthems of all time.
I haven't heard that one from them. Lonely, I gotta check that one out. Oh, hey, start me up. How could I forget
the
Rolling
two,
Stones?
The Rolling Stones.
Wow.
There are few British bands with as much instant international appeal as the iconic Rolling Stones. Maybe it's their raunchy, bluesy songwriting, or perhaps it's that stage magic which occurs between Stones frontman Mick Jagger and guitarist Keith Richards. Whatever the reason, there's no denying that this London rock institution has made commercial waves all over the world.
Oh, they have.
America most definitely included.
Wild horses.
For many, it's the Rolling Stones that define rock and roll at its purest, most distilled essence. So, who are we to argue? Before we name our number one pick,
yeah, I want to see honorable mentions.
Honorable mentions.
Show me.
You said no strings could secure you.
I haven't heard Cream in a long time. Is it Cream was a band of who was in Cream? Was it Eric Clapton? It was a group of people.
Sex,
Iron Maiden. Of course.
Number one, The Beatles.
Don't let me down.
If you have ever dabbled into music post 1960, it is practically...
Man, the Beatles.
Head with a genius which has rarely been equaled.
All the lonely people, where do they all come from?
British Invasion was just that when Beatles led an influx of English talent towards American shores. An incredible crossing over of talent whose legacy continues to be felt by artists around the world to this day.
I think it's the very first Beatles song I've heard.
Do you agree with
it? Okay, do I agree with this list? Yes. Do I think that there's a lot of bands that got left off? Rightfully so. But still, either way, man. You guys, if there's any bands that you think should have been mentioned in this top 10, let me know down below in the comment section. But I think rightfully, super great list. All the bands that were mentioned on this list, I think rightfully deserve to be there. And there's still a lot, man. And that just goes to show you the level of talent that the UK has produced in terms of music, artists, bands. You know what? There's a lot that didn't crack the US, but cracking the US don't mean that you're good or you're bad. You know? Some bands don't even want to crack the US market. But for these ones that did, you know, rightfully so, man. You know, their music is amazing. As far as surprising to me, I didn't expect to see Cream. For some reason, I don't know why. I wasn't thinking about Cream. But yeah, you guys, let me hear your thoughts on this. If this is your first time to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification below. And let me know which other videos you'd like me to check out. All the videos I react to on this channel come straight from you guys. So anything you guys want me to react to, just send it to me or comment it below and I'll check it out. Yeah, don't forget to like and share this video, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next one. It's been your boy, Jay. Peace.